Happy morning, children. Welcome to the next session of English. How are you all? Hope so you are all doing great and thereby listening to the recorded sessions which is being sent to you. Have a regular follow-up of the classes. Let us start today's session. Before going into today's session, I want to tell you something. I asked you to read first 8 points from the book. Which is the lesson we are seeing now? The title of the lesson is A Truly Beautiful Mind. What is the title of the lesson? A Truly Beautiful Mind. I asked you to read 8 points, first 8 points of the lesson. Do you think like why ma'am is not explaining each and every line of the text? Do you think like that? It is not going to benefit you if I am going to explain you the text line by line. So, what you have to do is, I will just highlight you few elements from the prose lesson and you are going to read the lesson. Whereas, in this lesson, A Truly Beautiful Mind, you could see that the first half of the lesson talks about the childhood of Albert Einstein and what did he do as a child and what did he do in his adulthood after reaching the age of 21, what was his contribution and which pattern of profession did he choose. All these things are covered till point number 10, whereas after that you could see the title A Truly Beautiful Mind is getting justified over there. How it is getting justified? After becoming a scientist, after becoming a research person, how his mind was beautiful? What are the things he has contributed? That plays a major role. And today's session is going to be something important where we are going to see part 2. Part 2 is the next half of the lesson, which is going to be a significant thing in the prose lesson. Shall we get into today's session then? Okay. Before that, in previous class, I told you, in 8th standard, you have read a lesson about Stephen Hawking. I asked you to go through the lesson and I asked you to tell me what is the thing you got inspired from the lesson. I asked you to give the title of the lesson. Have you found out the title of the lesson? Okay. Now, I have a project for you. The project for you is, you have to read about Stephen Hawking in class 8. Go through the text once again and gather information about his genius. I taught you the lesson line by line. And if you need any extra information, you can also search web resources. These are the steps you are going to follow. What made Hawking a genius? What made Stephen Hawking a genius? First, you are going to write, who is a genius? What are the attributes that a person make as a genius? These two questions you have to answer on your own. According to you, who is a genius? And as a genius, what are the qualities they should have? What are the attributes they should have? And how can you call Stephen Hawking a genius? What is he famous for? What books has he written? We have come across all these ideas, children. The book which is written by Stephen Hawking. And this lesson about Stephen Hawking, you know that it is a conversation between Stephen Hawking and Firdaus Ganga, a journalist from India. Refer to the obituaries written by people. What is called obituary, children? After the death of a person, we will write a concerned letter. That is called obituary. Obituary is written by people on him and find out his inspiring qualities. For this resource alone, you have to depend on net. All the other questions, you can get it from your textbook, 8th standard textbook. Who is a genius and what are the attributes? These two questions you have to write on your own. Whereas for the other three questions, you can get answer from your 8th standard textbook. Refer to the obituaries written by people on him and find out his inspiring qualities. You are going to do this like a project. Last lesson, I gave you a project, whereas I asked you to write something on rain, poem rain, and I asked if you can go with a poem of rain also, you can write. And I asked you to conduct an interview with your parent to know the things about generation gap. So this lesson project will be like this. You are going to do it on Stephen Hawking, a great scientist and who is also called as a genius. You can take 1 week time. You can take 1 week time as your periodic assessment 2 is fast approaching. I'll give you 10 days time, children. Okay. Two A4 sheets. A project of two A4 sheets with pictures of Stephen Hawking. You can take it from your 8th standard textbook and you can paste it. Pictures of Stephen Hawking, why you call him as genius, what are the qualities he has, you have to write. Shall we get into today's lesson then? What is a prose lesson for? A truly beautiful mind. And you all know that it is a lesson about Albert Einstein, a great physicist as well as a great scientist. This lesson is given a title as A Truly Beautiful Mind. What is something special about Albert Einstein then? What is a special quality he had? Last class, we have discussed 8 points. What were given in the 8 paragraphs? There, we could see about his childhood experiences and the stories of his childhood, when he studied college, when he entered into university. All these things we have seen. But there is no such thing interesting which gives things in this perspective. The lesson is titled as A Truly Beautiful Mind. When we read such thing, we could see that, we could find out that there is no such element portrayed over there. But in today's session, I am going to highlight you why this lesson has been titled as A Truly Beautiful Mind. Okay, in today's session, what I am going to do, children? I am going to justify, I'm going to highlight the ideas why this lesson is titled as A Truly Beautiful Mind. So today's session is going to be something important.